learn some
visible. So we'll start with mathematics, okay? And from the first question, it's limits. So the question is of limit, and I'll give you 2 minutes to solve this question.
Solve question as fast as you can, because you guys will get less than 1 minute to solve the question. 45 minutes.
Done, ma'am.
50 questions you have to do.
Done. What's your answer, Ragi?
Ma'am, one.
One.
Okay. I don't think that's the right answer. Let's just check. The answer is none of these, basically. So, what you have done in the question, I want to know. Because everybody would have followed the same strategy to get the first answer, right? What was your strategy?
Ma'am, I have used that formula 1 minus 2, cos 2x.
1 at a time. Gargi, you speak.
Ma'am, I have used that formula 1 minus cos 2x. Means cos 2x is equals to 2 cos square x minus 1.
Okay, so then you would have ended up with sine x
divided by x.
Yeah, so that will be mod sine x and not sine x, because when something comes out of the root, it is always in mod. So you don't get any answer to this question because that's in mod. What we have learned is sine x by x limit tending to 0 is 1. Okay, so that's the mistake there. Okay, second question. Anybody has a doubt here? I can write down and tell you.
Ma'am, can you repeat the thing after anything will come out after the mod? It is after the root. The
question was 1 by 2 and 1 minus cos 2x. Okay. Particularly, this thing is 1 minus cos 2x divided by 2. Which is what? So cos 2 theta is 2 cos square theta minus 1. Okay, now you can put this here. So what you will have? 1 minus 2 cos square theta minus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so here you will have 1 plus 1, this becomes 2, and minus 2 cos square theta divided by 2. So basically I can write this as 1 minus cos square theta, which is nothing but your sine square theta. Okay, now in the functions, when you read about root, you study this, that nothing in the root can be negative. The iota and all that we study is all imaginary. But in the real mathematics, nothing in the root is or can be negative. So whatever comes out of the root is always in the mod. And as we know that sine also accepts the negative value, so it is very essential here to put a mod sign here to clearly say that sine coming out of the root should always be positive. So we have put a mod here. So sine theta by theta and limit theta tending towards zero. That was your question, I guess. So this cannot be defined as we studied sine theta by theta limit tending to 0 is 1. This we haven't studied anything about this. Okay. Coming towards your next question of math. Function is defined such that sine x by x plus cos x for x not equal to 0. And it's 2k for x is equal to 0. So what should be the value of k? If it is continuous at x is equal to 0.
Ma'am, k is equal to 1 by 2.
Who is that?
Indrani, ma'am.
No. That's not the right answer, Indrani. Okay.
No, ma'am, I didn't get it.
Okay, what have you done to get k is equal to half?
Sin x by x plus cos x is equal to 2k. I took it like that, ma'am.
Sin x by x plus cos x is equal to
2k.
2k, fine then.
As it is continuous, applied limit to the k not equals to 0. I splitted the limits. I got 1 plus 1, that equals to 2k.
Yeah. So what have you done, Indrani, that you got the wrong answer?
Yeah, I substituted 0 in place of x, ma'am.
That's the only thing in the limit, that you don't have to put x is equal to 0 in the limit. You need to know some of the important limits, okay? You have to learn some of the important limits. So sin x by x, where x is tending to 0, is an important limit where the whole thing gets 1. And for cos x is equal to 0, when x is equal to 0, we know that cos is always 1. So no need to put any limit there. Okay?
Okay.
So you get okay. 2 basically.
Okay.
So that is equal to 2k. And 2 gets cancelled and k is equal to 1 there. Okay? Coming to the third question. Everybody understood, right? Do I have to do it again? On the screen maybe? Anybody wants that? In this question, can I write y is equal to sine inverse 3 x by 2 minus 4 x by 2 whole cube? It's the same as my question, isn't it? So this can be written as 3 sine inverse x by 2. One of the properties, correct? Now dy by dx. How will I write dy by dx? Take the constant as it is. Sine inverse x, what is the differentiation of that? 1 minus x squared by 4 and half, because there is a half here. This is 3 by 4 minus x squared. That's your A option.